What's up, guys? Middle Age Gamer here, yet again playing Transport Fever. Gonna keep this continuing on the America campaign. Let's go ahead and continue. Obviously, we've already uploaded videos of Wild West and Industrialization. Working on Panama Canal. I played this once last night. Didn't get all of the medals, but I know, or at least I think I know how to do it now. So this one was actually fairly easy, and I'm a little bit disappointed in this mission, and I'll tell you why at the end. I won't go into it right now. Let's go ahead and get it started, though. Wait for the game to load up. There we go. So we're young. We're in a tropical climate. Let's see here. The French project is actually swamped with problems, so now we're coming in to basically help out, is what that states. So basically, this is where they're digging right here. We don't actually dig any of this out. It's just a restricted area we can't get into. And we have to take stone out of this, I guess, quarry or dig site, which will basically, the more stone you take out, the more faster this digs all the way through to the other side. Let's look at the metals real quick. I'll kind of explain it. So basically, the first one's pretty simple. Make the president proud by ensuring that the canal can be completed before 1924. Again, it's just a time thing. Basically, have 20 years or so to completely remove all the stone and dig this entire canal. Secure funding. Do not go to an eight-figure sum. So anytime you get close to $10 million, you have to spend the money. And there's a lot of money to be made on this, which we'll get into in a little bit. Amaze the doctor. Save the golden frog, which I have yet to do. We'll go over that in a little bit. Landslide, basically you got to dig quick enough to where you get the metal, which basically means removing a lot of stone. I'm not sure if it's actually on a time frame you have to remove so much stone by a certain time, or if it's just the amount of stone that you move, but it's pretty easy. I didn't have any problems getting it last time I played this mission. And then fair distribution, which is probably the hardest one. Ensure there is no more than twice the amount of debris in one depression than the other, which we'll go over here in a little bit. So let's go ahead and start the mission under the overview. Okay, so the first thing it wants you to do is supply the central warehouse, which I'll show it to you right here, with 16 grain and 16 logs. So let's go ahead and set this up real quick, and we'll leave it in pause mode. Again, if you don't know already, this is a no-nonsense walkthrough. If you haven't played this mission, please go ahead and play the mission. That way you don't get any hints from what I do. But I'm going to show you what I think is best for this particular mission. This mission, I will admit, is relatively easy. There's probably 20 different ways you could do it. It's not as straightforward as the first two missions, but we'll go ahead and start it off. So first and foremost, we need to get grain over into the central warehouse here. Let's go ahead and set up a freight depot. So we're going to do a large truck station here. And really, money is not that big of an issue on this particular mission. So we'll go ahead and set that up, and then more importantly, we also need to set up a road depot over here as well. And then I also need a bus stop, I believe, for later on. So we'll go ahead and set up the bus stop right here. I guess we can put it right there. It doesn't really matter where it's at, per se. I'll put it down here. And then we also need a freight depot over here. I'll use a small one since we don't need a big one over here for any reason. So the grain will be offloaded on here automatically, and it will go down to the central warehouse. So that's part of it. We'll wait to get the trucks here in a minute. Let's look at the other two things. So we obviously need logs, which you can see right here. Supply the central warehouse with logs. And so there's logs and planks. First and foremost, we need to get logs only. So the log forest, whatever you call this place, produces the logs. So we got to take trucks directly from here to the central warehouse. So let's go ahead and set up another on the train. Let me go back. Truck station or freight depot, as I call it. There we go. And then we also need to set up a bus stop over here. Actually, we'll set up a large warehouse over here as well. There we go. Let's go ahead and get rid of the grain, or get the grain going first. We'll get a couple road vehicles. I'm going to use the American horse cart. It goes 12 miles per hour, which these roads right here only go 12 miles per hour. And the reason I'm doing that is so I don't have to upgrade the roads. You could upgrade the roads. You got plenty of money to do it. You could do steam lorries, but again, it's not a big deal whichever route you want to go. Let's just do 7 vehicles. That's fine for now. We'll set up a new line. And then we'll go from over here to the bus stop. Again, you can't go from truck station to truck station. That's why we have a bus stop there. Otherwise, the line won't run properly. So that's set up. Next and foremost, we need to set up the logs. So we'll go ahead and do that. So for that, let's go to the depot again. Oh, I'm clicking on the vehicle for some reason. There we go. By road vehicles. Get the American horse card again. Just gonna do 5 for this. Let's go ahead and set the new line for this. New line. And it is gonna go from this truck station all the way down to the bus stop again. That's good. Now we also want to run some logs down to make planks as well. Very important we do that. That's going to be pretty much the next step of the mission. So we'll go ahead and set that up for the time being. That way we don't have to do it in the future. Okay, that's good for that. Let's see, do I have the logs running? I forgot if I've already done that yet or not. So line one is the grain. So we need to run one more line. We need to take basically logs down to this area. Is it going down there though already? No, so we need one more line. Let me go ahead and do this. I'm gonna do 10 for this new line. It's gonna basically be going from this place to, and I need a truck or a bus station over here as well. That'll be going right there. There we go. Let's see if that all works out. Let's hit play real fast, make sure nothing's wrong with how we set up the lines. There'll probably be a big backup in this area. Again, the most important step right here is supply the central warehouse. So we're getting the grain from the farm, which will take a while to come out. All right, so now we've got to set up the lines for the planks. So what's going to happen basically is we've got to take planks from this warehouse, which will automatically unload to the freight station here. And we've got to bring them to three places, 1, 2, and 3, basically to drain the swamps. And you can keep those lines running because these will actually accept up to 50 at a time as far as the consumption goes. And it consumes pretty quickly. So we got to set up all this real quick. Let's go ahead and do that. We'll probably do 5 on each. There we go. We got 5. Let's go ahead and set the line. So we're going to have a ton of lines going, as you can obviously see. One there, 2 up here. And we got to set bus stations first. Forgot about that. All right, that's one of the lines right there. Let's go ahead and set up the other two. We gotta put bus stations first. Bus stations basically, I know it sounds like you have to use passengers, but basically it's just a stopping point for it to unload the goods. As long as the area you want to unload is within the highlighted section of the bus station, it will automatically unload, just in case you guys are wondering. Again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let me go ahead and set the line for this new line. We'll be going from here all the way up here. There we go. And need to buy 5 more for the last line. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And we're going to set this line again from the planks area all the way to the other swamp over here. This is going to all take a while to get going. Obviously for the grain to start coming out. The grain's already starting to come out, which is good. At least I thought it was. Oh yeah, this guy has some grain on there. And the logs should be coming out, which they are. Let's go ahead and speed this process up and look towards the next step. Next step is kind of hard. It's going to be basically taking all of the rock out of here. Okay, so definitely want to be careful with the golden frog. We're going to have to move some roads around, which is basically this road right here. Let's go ahead and adjust this because we're going to be transferring a lot of rock from here over to the dam east, and we do not want to go through this circle for any reason whatsoever. It's very important that we don't go through any of these circles. Otherwise, the chance of survival goes down tremendously just by even driving through here with cargo. So let's go ahead and reroute this real quick while we got some time. There we go. I'm actually going to upgrade most of this line altogether. Alright, let's go ahead and do this medium road, which should be fine, hopefully. There we go. I don't know how much it would cost to actually upgrade that. I don't want to get rid of it. I just want to know how much it would cost to go straight across. We'll go ahead and do that. Speed the process up down the road. And I'll go ahead and do this. I'll show you guys why I did that later on. Don't need to really go into it now. In fact, I might want to bring this over here. And let's go ahead and get rid of this little section here. So we're going to have to put a train depot in this area, so it's very important we get that out of the way. I should have ran that road a little bit closer, but I think we'll be fine to get two or three train lines through that little area right there. At least I hope so. If not, we can always adjust down the road if we need to it. So I'm a little worried the chance of survival is actually falling. It shouldn't be though. Let me set up some trees in the area maybe. We're not going through this circle. We're not going through a circle down there. Why would it be falling? I don't know. It shouldn't be. I don't know if this makes any difference whatsoever to add in trees. I'm just going to brush them on while we have it in play mode. In fact, I'm going to go ahead and speed this up just a little bit. Trying to cover up that area where the road was at. There you go, now it's starting to rise again. Maybe it's because I bulldozed those roads. Could be the reason. Okay. Rising is good, that's all we want. And now it's just a matter of waiting for the planks to start going. Which we do, we already have planks over here, which is good. So it's a matter of the horse carts going from all the way here, all the way out here, which most of these are probably empty. I could go ahead and turn them around. As it takes a while for the resources to get going. Empty, and this one's probably empty as well. Let's go ahead and turn all these guys around. These guys are probably going to be empty. They're already heading back, though, so that's fine. Just hopefully we have enough planks going. I might need to run some more lumber down here. Would be the only issue. Let's go ahead and do a couple more road vehicles. Set line would be, I think it's going to be 5. Nope. Be line 4. All right, so here's the bulk of the mission right here. We basically got to remove 5,000 stone altogether from this area. And it says we got to move the material to Dam West and Dam East and then dispose of the remaining material in Dump North and Dump South. What we're going to focus on right now is getting the stone to Dam East and Dam West for the time being, which, as you can see right here, this one is Dam East, I believe, and then Dam West is all the way up here. So obviously we're going to have to use trains for that, and we can use road vehicles for the one below. Anyways, let's go ahead and set the easy one, which is just this road network right here. That'll be first and foremost. Let's go ahead and click on here. We need a large truck station. Let's go ahead and get that set up. There we go. And then we need a bus station down here to drop it off, obviously. Put it right there, should be fine. Then we need another road depot, of course, so they don't have to drive all the way from the other area. And I'm going to put this out of the way as much as possible. Let's put it down here. There we go. And I'm just going to buy basically a ton of horse carts. Well, actually, this road can go. We upgraded the road. Let me see how fast that road goes. 25 miles per hour. Might just do steam lorries. These guys do 16 miles per hour. This should be fine. Let's go ahead and do steam lorries then. We'll start off with a couple and see how it goes. I don't want this line to go too quickly. And I'll explain my reasons why in a little bit. There we go. And more importantly, we've got to set up the freight line as well. So that will be the most important one. We're going to do an end station. I do want 4 tracks if I can get it. I may not need all 4, but it's better to go ahead and do this now than later. It's a matter of can I might have to extend that road out. Let me go ahead and do that. Now let's try it now on the end. There we go. And before I run anything, let me just see. So we're going to have one going, probably run 2 lines up to there while we have trucks just delivering from to Dam East. We're going to have 2 trains going to Dam West more than likely. And I'll probably use the center 2 tracks on here. Need to keep room for 1 on the right side and 2 on the left side, it looks like. Hopefully that's good. Do this in short sections. Don't want that. Going to be the biggest cost is basically going down this huge downward incline right there. Again, money's not really that big of an issue on this particular mission, but if you can avoid contours, which should probably set this up, avoid the bigger mountains, save a little bit of money would probably be best. It's looking decent so far. That was an expensive section though. I'm going to set up the other side real quick. And for this, we're going to set up, again, an end station with two tracks is what we need. Make sure that it does get highlighted as far as the dam right there to make sure it automatically unloads, which that should be fine right there. And let's see, I think we're using the right side of the track. I just want to make sure we're using the same one down there. So yeah, using the right side. We'll connect this to the right side as well. And now more importantly, we do need a depot. I'll put the depot down here. It'll be a little bit easier to connect to. So train depot. This doesn't matter which way it goes. Probably needs to go the other way first. Put it like that. Make sure we can connect the track. That'll work out fine. And let's go ahead and buy a train. So the gondolas, we have to get a bunch of gondolas. We probably want the more expensive ones with 12 capacity. And if we can go up to 75 miles per hour. I'm afraid to use the more expensive one. Does, what speed is that? 62. I'm probably gonna use the mogul. It's a hard decision. Yeah, let's use the mogul. And then now I gotta get it to where it gives me the loan. May need to get just a regular gondola. I don't wanna do that either though. So it won't give me money, but I have to spend it on something. I'll buy one of these to get the loan and then sell it back is what I'll probably do. Oh, there, got the takeout loan right there. That's what I needed. Thank you for letting me do that. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Take out the last loan and we'll do one more for the road. Go ahead and set the line. Going upper Panama all the way down to Colon South, which is basically Dam West. Take the contour lines off. I don't need that right now. Put it in 4X. So we're starting to get the planks delivered to the swamps, which is good. The chance of survival for the golden frogs raising, which is good as well. Probably should have left those roads in the circle to be on the safe side, but again, not really a big deal. And you can see we're already removing stone automatically because if you come down here, the stone's getting transferred over here and counts up. So we'll add a little bit more steam lorries once this gets a little bit more backed up as needed. Looks like we don't need any right now. These lorries are actually pretty quick on this road, which is good. But our money, our major money maker is going to be this train. Once it really starts getting going. There we go. Drain swamps 2 is done. We need 1 and 3. Which they all seem to be doing pretty good. Keep that going. Eventually I'll run an entire second line without any crossings down to the Dam West because, as you can see, Dam East is going to be getting quite a bit of stone compared to Dam West, even with two trains going. If we fill this guy up with steam lorries, it's going to be a lot quicker than the two trains. All right, we'll go ahead and get a couple more steam lorries going. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Set the line. There we go, line 8. It hopefully shouldn't be overkill on the steam lorries. Seems like it's backing up a little bit right there. You can see all the steam lorries are basically coming at once, though. So hopefully they'll start spreading out on their own slowly. And my hope is they're also, finance-wise, they're making money on the trip as well. I know if you use the American horse cart, you do make money. I've never tried the steam lorries as of yet, so it should be relatively interesting. You can see they're starting to spread out a little bit more, which is good. Little bit of overkill, but I think the quarry will speed up as far as how much rock it puts down. And while it's doing that, we can go ahead and start running this second line. Again, it's going to be really expensive at this part. You could combine this part of the track before the bridge to save money, but again, we'll have plenty of money coming down the road, so I'm not too worried about it. I don't want to have to worry about trains waiting on each other either. There's really no need on this particular mission. Get down to about 400k. And then we'll stop here in just a second until we can make some money. There we go. Let's go ahead and leave it as is. Again, don't worry about going negative initially. As long as you get this one train set up and running between the dig site, excuse me, in the dams, and you'll be more than fine. Just need a few more planks to swamp one. So about half the train full on that. Hoping it's at least going to pay for itself on this particular trip. It should be in the negative on here right now. Yeah, still in the negative on the financials, but again, not that big of a deal. Now we just sit back and let it coast for a little bit. The Golden Frog chance of survival is still going up. And really, it's really important to get rid of that road. You could technically probably leave the road and do a little bit better. But you make sure to take all these either horse carts or steam lorries around the green circle. Don't run any train tracks through the circle. Be a very, very bad day if you do that. I could add more steam lorries, but I don't want the dammies to get way too far ahead. I really need to get two trains going, possibly three trains going, to deliver the stone. Alright, so we just delivered the stone right there. We have over 1 million already. Keep a close eye on how much money you have. Make sure you don't go above 10 million into 8 figures for any reason. Otherwise, you will not get that 5th gold medal, and it will be a bad day for everybody. And I won't look like a good instructor to you guys, so. There we go. We've got two full lines going now. And what I'm going to do is actually delete this connection. I'm going to run it to the other track. Just to keep things simple. And then, just in case, I'll put up a couple of stop areas here, worst case scenario. That way I don't stop either train from entering the other track. And we'll start buying a train once we get a little bit more money. So I'm going to hold off on buying a train for right now. Let's see if this one is full quite yet. Hopefully it is. Nope, still not full. And then once that gets delivered, we'll buy at least the locomotive, if not start buying some gondolas as well. The gondolas are very, very expensive for the high-end ones like what we have. It's basically a little bit over $500,000, which is a lot of money. If needed, we could buy a cheaper train, but until this one really fills up, I'm not too concerned with it. Probably buy a couple more steam lorries, though. Buy a few more. There we go. Let's see how much this guy makes at the end here. $1.75 million, which is good. So, choose one of two options. We definitely want to pay the engineers in gold coins. Yeah, because I want the vehicle operating costs to be minus 10%, which is going to help out quite a bit. Let's go ahead and buy another train real fast. We'll buy another mogul, so they're running the same speed. And it's going to buy at least one gondola. And we'll hold off on buying anything else for the time being. Again, keep your money down as much as possible, because before you know it, if you have two trains running, you can easily go over 10 million, especially towards the end of the mission. All right, I do want to look at these guys' finances. Okay, so we're making money with the steam lorries, which is good on this trip. That's what we want. And Dam West is kind of keeping up with Dam East. We can always increase production of Dam East as well. We got quite a few more years to go, so I'm not too concerned with it. You can see, the more rock we take out of here, the more they actually start digging this canal right there. Which will bring me back to why I'm so disappointed in this mission once we finish it up. I'm not going to go over it right now, but at the end, I will let you guys know. All right, almost full train right there. Buy just a few more steam lorries. They're definitely outpacing the train. Again, my hope is to add another train here shortly, though. Follow this guy around. Okay, make sure to stay outside of these green circles. We're already at 60% on the chance of survival for the frog. We need to get to 80%. Yeah, so 80% chance of survival to save the species. We should definitely be there by the end of the mission. All right, let's see how much we get from this delivery. Almost full train. 2.58 million. It's quite a bit. Let's go ahead and add more gondolas. You can see the old gondola has already gone, because once you get past a certain year, you can't buy the cheaper gondola. So you have to end up buying this one. It's almost 600,000. And I'm gonna go ahead and run this train, but then I'm gonna upgrade it after the next run. In fact, I'm gonna go ahead and buy another one. Even if we go negative, it's not a big deal. And I'll set the line. Once this gets to the other side, I'll go ahead and set the line for the train. We will go negative more than likely here shortly. Not a big deal again. We're making plenty of money. Just don't hit the end screen when you get the little notice saying you went negative. Again, I could have not bought that gondola. I could sell it right now to make sure I don't go negative, but it's not a big deal if you do go negative. As long as you have positive cash flow throughout the year, you're fine. Once it gets farther down, I'll go ahead and release this locomotive. You can see the trains right there. We got all our steam lorries going, which is good. I really need to get the second train out, so let's go ahead and set the line now. And let's go release the hounds. There we go. Make sure he's coming out and he doesn't get stuck at the track for any reason. Do not click on that, as unfortunate. Just get rid of the money depleted. Don't worry about it. Now we have two trains on two separate tracks going. The steam lorries are definitely going really, really quick as far as getting all the stone out. So we'll probably change the line over to, I wonder if I can just do a new line by itself without doing anything on it. There we go, landslide. We needed that. So it's going to be Panama North. Just in case we have to use the steam lorries to deliver stone all the way out here. I don't think we'll have to, but you never know. Oh, I don't have money to even put the line in, so I'll hold off on it. Not a big deal. We can finish that line in a little bit. All right, full train coming. Should be just over $2 million. Get rid of that negative balance. Oh, 3 million. That's a surprise, actually. And where's the other train at? Just wanted to look at it real quick. That's actually full. I should have set up my train depot a little bit differently. Instead, what I'm going to do is actually set up another train depot to upgrade the other train. So let's do that right now. Let's click on this. There we go. Go ahead and buy a gondola or two to keep the money down. Go. Keep those in the depot for now. Speed it up. At this point, I probably could have bought a third train. We've got enough steam lorries going back and forth. We could always upgrade the speed of that if we want to, but our trains aren't quite keeping up yet. Good news is we've got two trains going and plenty of stone to remove from the station as well. Okay, let's go ahead and send them to the depot real quick. Upgrade this guy. In fact, let's sell this off. Let's go ahead and add these guys up there. We're gonna buy a new locomotive. Go ahead and buy this one since we got some money to burn. Two. We'll buy two more gondolas and send this guy on his way. There we go. That's a more respectable train right there. I could definitely add a lot more gondolas on there. what I wanted. There's any way to get that out that way or not. And nope. Should have done a little bit better job of setting those up, but not a big deal. Another full train. So you can see basically 3 million each time a train goes back and forth. It's pretty insane. So next step, what we're going to do is worry about the distribute stone. I'm going to make a path to this area over here, which is dump south. And then we need to make a train path all the way up to dump north as well. And since we have a couple $1 million to spend, we're going to make new tracks the entire way. Not that we really need it, but we got to waste this money one way or another. So again, we'll just have this track follow this guy all the way around. Try to burn as much money up as possible. Definitely build an expensive bridge right here. Spend as much money as possible again on that. And then we need to end a, I guess not end a, but put in another freight station here. Ooh, it's gonna be really, really close. It's not gonna connect no matter what we do, is it? How do I salvage that? Oh well, I can always delete that entire section. Waste money, which is what we need to do. Definitely a big money waster right there. There we go. That definitely burned some money right there, which is good. That's what we want to do. And we can build the four track all the way over to the other dump site. Again, saving money is not what you want to do on this mission. Trust me on that one. If anything, we've probably set up a third train is what I might actually do. Let's go ahead and run a fourth track right now. I might use this fourth track for a third train to distribute stone to Dam West, and then we can switch it over to dump it if we need to. Let's wait till that guy gets to the end down there, get some more money. There we go, got 3 million. Let's go ahead and pause it while we build the track. Like I said, saving money is not something you want to do on this particular mission. And we want this to go to basically the same place if at all possible. Do is actually expand this station. Let's go ahead and upgrade it to four platforms there. And let's connect it to this fourth side. There we go. and now what we can do is actually start buying another expensive train. Wait till this train is delivered coming down. So we're almost done with Dam East. It's only 1911. We have until, I think, what was it, 1924 to ensure the canal is done. So we got plenty of time, which is good. That guy looks like it's only holding 17 stone. That's not good. Not sure why that slowed down so much. I think maybe it thought I was doing too good of a job. Right, at least that one's halfway full. That's positive. Probably end up doing the mogul since it's a million. No reason to do the Atlantic. Already got one of those running. I'm not sure if that's even going to be positive cash flow. Yeah, that one's positive. Not sure if that was the right engine, though. Alright, so that train didn't really make any money. We'll end up going negative. Again, not a big deal. So we'll save up money until we get another train going. Some gondolas with that. Is that the upgraded? Yeah, that's the faster locomotive. The other one's top speed was 47. This one is 62. So you can see it makes quite a bit of difference on the top speed right there. Financial, it's actually making money. Should make quite a bit more money as long as the stone starts loading back up, which it should be. There we go. That's what you want to see. You want to see it loading up on the platforms there. There we go. Full train going. That's good. I don't really like how close the trains are together, but I guess I could always stop this one if I wanted to. I'm just gonna keep it going. Hopefully that's halfway at least. Yep, about halfway, that's fine. I'll take that. We're almost to 1,000 of 1,000 on Dam East. And what happens is we'll actually switch this line over to Dam West to unload the 2,000 needed up there. And then we'll have a third train going. And then we'll worry about taking everything to the dumps north and south as needed. Oh, it looks like we had a problem here. Sawmill. It's just basically full. That's fine. We'll let that one go. We don't really need to worry about that. Should be hopefully 3 million right there. Yep. Gonna buy some more gondolas. There we go. Not gonna let the fourth or third train go quite yet. Alright, if we had to do sawmills, I guess let's go ahead and do this. Might as well. So these are all the American horse carts. Set a line out there. Buy some more horse carts. And we'll set a line out there as well. There we go. I should hopefully get rid of this sawmill issue. It's 1.5 million. going to buy two more gondolas, and let's go ahead and release this train. Again, we could add way more gondolas, but we need to worry about getting as much stone as we can over. So let's set this one up on its own line. Know why it's on. Let me try this. I want to go via that track instead on the way on the very end. There we go. Now it's on the correct platform. In fact, I want to stop that guy. I don't want it to be... Got to stop one of these. Let's go ahead and stop this guy. We already got two trains running back to back, so I'm going to wait till these guys start coming back. In fact, I might want to stop this one too, to spread them out a little bit more. And this is wasting a lot of money right here. In fact, I need to do another thing while we're doing that. Let's see if these steam lorries are still picking up and taking rock down there. There they are. I'm gonna have to end all the steam lorries going out here in just a second, but we'll keep it going for now. Alright, that guy's gone down there, that guy's going down, and once one of this guy's, I guess one of the trains starts getting back to the middle going that way, we'll send the other train out as well. So you're making some good time on the canal right there. That's a goal for this mission, is to basically dig out the entire canal, which is why we're removing so much stone and taking those out. We'll unstop that third train here in just a little bit. Let's go ahead and unstop them now. That way they're spread out just a little bit more. They don't have to be perfect, but that's a lot better than what it was. We're almost at 80% of chance of survival, which is good too. Let's go look at the train coming in for money. Then we'll look at the steam lorries here in just a second. It's only 1913. Still got plenty of time to remove the stone. We're over halfway of removing the stone, which is good. And it looks like I'm hitting all of the gold medals as I need to right now. There we go. That got us in the positive by just over a million, which is good. Let's see if the lorries are still delivering or not. They're not. So what we need to do is basically go back into slower mode. And let's make sure all these have delivered is the real issue. They have not. Alright, so basically what we need to do is send all these back to the depot that are not delivering. Gonna be a lot of these to do. You could actually look at the line and click on all of them in a row, but I want them to deliver whatever rock they have left for the ones that are actually delivering. Make sure he's heading to the depot, and we'll just go down the line and do all these real fast. You can keep an eye on your money, make sure you don't get close to 10 million, otherwise you do got problems. Get all these guys into the depot. Alright, so we have 4 million already. Let's actually pause it just in case. And let's see, what can we do to burn up some more money? We got lines running pretty much everywhere. What I'll do is just buy a locomotive. It's the only thing I can think of. I'll just buy some more gondolas for the hell of it, too. Okay. Get back down here. Make sure these guys are heading to the depot, which they are. This guy's headed for the depot as well. Okay, so everybody's heading to the depot. We'll give that just a minute. More importantly, let's go ahead and set up bus stops here as we need to. There we go. We got a bus stop on that dump site, and we have a bus stop on this dump site as well. Still got about, 10 years to go. Plenty of time. Once all these guys get in here, whoa, there's still another guy going down there, isn't there? Let's get this guy to go to the depot. Waiting for a train to make a delivery. And then we'll set up the routes to both dump stations with the steam lorries. You could also do trains, of course. I'm going to keep the trains going to Dam West, though, for the time being. Excuse me. Okay. Can't even get to the bottom of that. Jesus. Is there any way to edit the window so I can see the bottom or not? Nope. That sucks. Let me just sell a couple so I can see. Won't even let me sell it. What the hell? That'd be nice to be able to edit that. That's fine. Whatever. Let's set up a line, which is what we need to do first anyway. So go to the line screen. I think line 11 needs to be set up. So does line 10. So let's do line 10 first. That will be to, that station, Panama North, all the way down to this dump site, which they are naming the Crescent. And let's set up line 11. I'm going to go ahead and remove this, which I think that's actually the correct station, but just in case, Panama North, all the way to this dump site right here. And I gotta figure out if there's an easy way to get all these guys on the same line or not. Can I shift them? Nope, can't shift them. There we go. Had to sell a few of them to get down here. So we're gonna go ahead and set line on all these two. Let me make sure we're going the right way. Line 10. And let me go ahead and stop it because I don't want to. Set line to line 11, which is the closer one. I actually want to buy a few more. set line to. Can't see which one it is. Line 10 on that. There we go. And we got 4 million in the bank, which is not good. Oops, let me sell one of these guys. And it may run actually run a fourth line to the dump site, which there is one right there. Let me go ahead and run this real quick. Go. And stop it right there until we get some more money. I don't know why that one's not running full. It's kind of weird. Been running like that for a while. Almost feel like we should just sell it and get rid of it. Looks like it's starting to build up on the fourth line right there, so we'll hold off. Most of these steam lorries are going to be running without any stone initially, but as they come back around, it will get better. That's an awful sound, though, with all the steam lorries going. You can see it's going to be a massive backup for a while until they get all spread out. The only thing I'm a little worried about is distribute stone. I think I did the lorries correctly. I can always adjust them as they go and switch which lines they're heading to, just in case. But ensure there is no more than twice the amount of debris in one depression than the other one. So that's all we have to worry about. Golden Frog's doing good. We're almost at 90%, so no issues with that whatsoever. Got a full train going down. Actually, two full trains going down. So gotta keep an eye on the money, make sure we don't get too high. And I'm hoping that third train actually picks up stone this time around because it's been running a negative balance for a while. I'm not quite sure why. Maybe because I had it on hold for a while. All right, so we're at 1 million right now. Should be at 3, 4. Yep, we're at about 4 right now, which is good. All right, pick up this at least. Fourth train. Hopefully you can do that for me. Yep, okay, we're good. Starting to make money now. Let's go spend some money now. I feel like I'm saying money now a lot. And we're going to do something absolutely ridiculous. We're just going to go across the water and then back to burn off some money. Again, completely pointless in any other scenario where money is a factor. This is not one of those scenarios, though. I'm actually going to go ahead and work out this area right here. How about that? Hopefully that will work. What I'm trying to do. Yeah, that's exactly what I wanted to do right there. Perfect, and then I need to set this up so I can get into the fourth track somehow. Let's see. Let me go ahead and set up the signals real quick so it can get by at least. In fact, I'll need one of these down here. Just in case. That should be it. All right. Set this up to my only concern is the distribution of stone, excuse me, which again, take a close eye on this train and see how much it carries over. Again, just wasting money buying trains I don't need. Got two trains going at the same time. That's kind of cool, actually. But my focus is not that. My focus is going to be on getting stone to the dump north site to even out the distribution. If I could talk, that would be a lot better, too. Good amount going, which is good. That should hopefully even it out a little bit once we get over there. Let's see how the steam lorries are doing to this other dump site. Are they getting there? Not quite yet. Nope. There they are. I've got some going up there, which is good. We'll just watch this train in the meantime. Buy some gondolas so we don't go over our $10 million issue. There we go. Got 1% in the north, which is good. I'm hoping this train will even it out just a little bit, though. There we go. Percentage is looking a lot better now. And we're getting up to the 5,000 of 5,000 too. So just going to continue to keep a close eye on that. Make sure it doesn't go down. Really want it to get to about 50-50 and then try to stop some of the lorries if I need to. Again, this is the time of the game where you really want to keep a close eye on your money. Make sure you don't get above that 10 million because it will sneak up on you relatively quickly. We're almost to 2,000 of 2,000 on the dam too, which is good. And we're almost to 50-50. Thank you. And we're only on 1917, so we're doing really, really good as far as the time goes. All right, we're at 50-50 now. We do have a train going up to Dump North. So I'm going to send these to Dump South is what I'm probably going to do. Set line. I think it's line 11. Set line, line 11. What I might want to do is reroute this guy to Dump South and burn up some money because we've got plenty of money. I don't want to do this scenario again. I'm not sure this is going to work. Hopefully we can reroute the existing line without losing the cargo on board. This would be a good way to burn up some money too. Dump South is actually just right there. So we can build a tunnel. Building a tunnel will definitely help burn some money up. And let me put the freight station here. Let's see. So make it short. Let's make it 5 tracks to burn up a little bit of more money. And other than that, might want to buy some more gondolas. Keep the money down again. There we go. Much, much better. I'm going to go ahead and remove that. And we're going to set a waypoint. Track that, set a waypoint over here, and we'll go ahead and add a station. There we go. All right, doing pretty good so far. Removal of stone will probably slow down a little bit. All right, we're at 50-50. Now I'm questioning, should I do more to Dump North or not? I don't know which way this thing is going right now. How about this? Let me buy some trucks. Set line all to line, was it line 11 or line 12? I don't remember. Line 10. Change the distribution up a little bit as we get going. So we're going to go ahead and change this guy's line to line 10. If for any more guys to come by as well. All right, 4,900. We only got about 100 more stone to worry about. I just want to make sure this train doesn't deliver the stone to dump south. So I'll just turn it around and stop it as I have to. Set line 10. It's kind of a cheap way to do it, but it definitely ensures that you don't have too much of a distribution problem. Just want to keep an eye on that train up there. It's my only issue. 4,900. Distribution's looking okay. All right, so that was obviously a pretty easy mission. What I was going to mention earlier that I did not like about this particular mission, you think Panama Canal, you think of, oh, I get to finally use boats now. And I'm not sure, was I supposed to use boats? Because really there was nothing in the mission that made any mention of using boats. And in fact, the boat icon, as you can see, is not even lit up. So I'm a little disappointed that they didn't include the use of boats. Look at the screenshot right there with the boat going down the river. Why can we not use boats in this mission? Doesn't make any sense to me. I guess it's not a big deal either way. If you haven't yet already, hit the subscribe button below you. Definitely helps me out making future videos. You can also follow me at twitch.tv/themiddleagedgamer and watch my live streams of this game, Train Sim, Battlefield 1, and all sorts of other games. Mainly simulator games, but I do play a little bit of everything. Anyways, glad you guys tuned in to watch. Hopefully this helped you guys out. If you have any questions or comments, submit them below, even if it's about the game or if you weren't sure why it did something. Feel free to ask below and I'll definitely walk you through why I did what I did. Anyways, appreciate it, everybody. Cheers, and I'll see you guys next time.